What is it that a man wants from his wife? What is the primary emotion that he wants from his wife? Well, the primary emotion, according to modern psychologists, I'll bring in the Quran and Sunnah later. The primary emotion that men want from their wives is that of respect. That of respect. When a wife respects her husband, when a wife shows respect to her husband, the husband reciprocates that respect by giving the woman her primary need. And what is the need that the woman has? What is the primary need that a woman wants from her husband? What's the primary emotion? That is the continual love and the continual enveloping of that attention that the husband always makes his wife his priority. The husband always shows his wife that I'm thinking about you, I'm caring about you, i.e. I will always love you. So, what does the man want? Respect. When he gets respect, what does he do? He gives what the wife wants. What does the wife want? To feel loved, to feel cherished, to feel always thought about, taken care of, that the priorities of the husband are the feelings of the wife. And when the husband is shown respect, he will reciprocate by giving his wife that love. And when the wife is loved, she will reciprocate by giving the husband the respect that he deserves. So I want to talk a little bit about these two emotions. What does it mean, respect and love? These are empty words until we translate them into realities. And by the way, I can bring in the Quran and Sunnah to demonstrate this reality. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الرِّجَالُ قَوَّامُونَ عَلَى النِّسَاءِ, that men are qawwam over women. And qawwam means to be in charge of. This is the literal meaning of the Quran. Qawwam means the one who will take care of the other. Qawwam means the one who will be the one in charge. So what is the one in charge? The one who is shown respect. And we have that famous hadith. And no doubt this hadith is misused and abused. And we have to point this out as well. But it is the famous hadith that when once Mu'adh ibn Jabal came back from Syria, and he entered the masjid of the Prophet ﷺ, and he fell down in sajda in front of the Prophet ﷺ. And the Prophet ﷺ said to him, Ya Mu'adh, what are you doing? Who told you to prostrate to me? Why are you doing this? So Mu'adh ibn Jabal said, I returned from Syria. I found the people prostrating to their rabbis and their elders out of respect. And I felt you deserve this respect more than those priests and those rabbis. What did our Prophet ﷺ say? It's a famous hadith. I should say it's an infamous hadith. All of you have heard of it. But I want to be clear here. It's not my job to apologize on behalf of what the Prophet ﷺ said. It's not my job to cover up his teachings. It is my job to teach those teachings, whether a person likes them or not. If I didn't do that, I would not be worthy of standing where I'm standing. What did the Prophet ﷺ say? Verily, Allah has forbidden any human to prostrate to another human. Hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim, Abu Dawud and Tirmidhi. It's clearly authentic. Verily, Allah has forbidden any human to prostrate to another human. But if he were to have allowed this, if a concession were to have been made, there is no concession. If a concession were to have been made, I would have told the wife to prostrate to her husband out of what the respect and duty she owes to him. Now, what is this prostration? It is the prostration of respect. The prostration of respect. And what does this show? That the wife gives respect to the husband. And what will the husband give back? The husband will give back that love, that cherishing, that nurturing that the wife craves. So the question is, what does it mean for the wife to respect the husband? So what does it mean to show him respect? A few very specific points. Number one, respect his knowledge and his judgment. Wives, respect your husband's knowledge and judgment. When your husband makes a decision, don't double guess him. Don't doubt him. Don't try to make him feel he's not intelligent, he's not qualified to do what he's doing. In other words, don't treat him like a child. Classic example, happens all the time. Husband is driving and the wife thinks that this is the wrong way. The wife says, no, you should exit here. You just missed the highway exit. This is where you're supposed to exit from, right? What has just happened here? The husband becomes irritated. I know where I'm going. Don't worry. I know it's right ahead, right? What's happened here? Well, the wife has doubted her husband's sense of power, sense of being in charge, sense of responsibility. And what happens here when a husband is challenged, he becomes, what's he going to become when he's challenged? Argumentative. He becomes, immediately he'll retort back, what do you know? You did this, you did that. Now, if he turns out to be wrong and you were right, this leads me to point two. Suppose you were right, that was the exit. Well then, this leads me to point two. Let the husband make his mistakes and learn from his own mistakes. Because when he makes a mistake, he won't be able to get angry at anybody else. And don't become his mother. Believe me, no man wants to marry a motherly figure. He has his mother, alhamdulillah, for that. He doesn't want his wife to start lecturing him, to start daunting him, like only his mother is allowed to daunt him. Right? Mothers have privileges they don't extend to their daughter-in-laws. Don't be sarcastic or diminishing of any project he feels that he wants to do. So for example, there's a leaky faucet and your husband comes in with the toolbars, the plumbing, the wrench and everything, and you're like, you're gonna fix the leaky faucet? What have you just done? You've taken his ego and you didn't just take a pin and you took a knife and you thrust it in his heart. Like literally the husband will say, if I can't even take care of a leaky faucet, you don't think I'm capable of this, what do you think I'm capable of? What you've done is, and I'm gonna be very frank here, and I speak as a man, men, I'm sorry and I apologize for giving the secret away, but I have to for our own marriages. Men, I know this is gonna come as a shock to you sisters, men have big egos. I know it's going to come as a shock to you. Their egos, mashallah, tabarakallah. So, if you do anything to diminish that ego, you have hurt male pride. You have hurt male pride. So, you let the man foster his ego. Let him, if you think he's self-deluded, let him be self-deluded. He'll love you back in return.